management for Marine and Professor Kue, my intimate friend, also from Japan, long period. I think I'm not new to KDU since 2002. I was a consultant for them. Anyway, we will try to concentrate on one particular issue. I'm a social scientist, so I would like to discuss one important aspect, a very simple aspect in our society we have neglected. So I selected the topic as importance of literacy for managers and entrepreneurs in the 21st century. We can ask a simple question before we start our presentation. So my simple question, today I'm trying to answer, why Sri Lanka is a lower middle income country with 4,000 per capita income? Why Sri Lanka is a, in other words, if I say developing country, not still emerging country. So why? The simple answer, what I am developing these days, is that, of course, you can see the lack of entrepreneurs, lack of businesses in Sri Lanka. So that is my simple answer. So I will come to that with some data. Of course, labor force survey data, you know, the labor force survey is conducted by Department of Census and Statistics. According to that, there are only 229,000 employers in Sri Lanka. In other words, less than 230,000 employers in Sri Lanka. Employers means who have given the jobs to others. So if you compare that with Japan, I will show you that the situation is entirely different. So why Sri Lanka is poor? Only 2.9% of people are the business owners. The others, you have on-account workers and other facts as well. So now simply you can understand that. With that, we can go to a Sri Lankan classification of businesses. How many businesses here? You can see the in 2013, Department of Census and Statistics again did a survey, economic establishments in Sri Lanka. It's, of course, you can see totally, that is 1 million enterprises in Sri Lanka. Of course, micro enterprises are the largest, and the number of enterprises are very less in Sri Lanka. And if you compare the SME contribution in Sri Lanka with other countries, you can see here the our country contribution is less to GDP, only 52% coming from the small firms. And of course, this is one of the reasons, because people have not started businesses in this country. Now this is the Japanese situation. You can see how many enterprises in Japan. 4.2 million businesses are in Japan. 4.2 million businesses. So out of that, only 12,000 large businesses, and small businesses, 4.1 million businesses. So we are trying to, in other words, if I say there are at least 4.2 million entrepreneurs or business owners or employees. So that is the difference between developed country and developing country, because we can provide jobs for many people, but the issue is whether they create value, whether they add something to the production is very important. Now you can see the importance of SME sector in Japan here. So it is the largest. Almost 99% of businesses are SME, and of course employees. You can see employment, around 40 million people employed in SME sector in Japan. So I will come to this point again. Why we could not develop entrepreneurship in Sri Lanka? Why we could not have more enterprises in Sri Lanka? Basic, my argument lies with the literacy. You know what is literacy? In simple, conventional definition for literacy is the ability to read and write. So if you go by that definition, we have 93% of Sri Lankans are literate, and we can write and read and write in only one language. Right? So the evolution of the literacy definition came into later competence or knowledge in a specified area. But in today's world, the literacy definition has emerged into many components. To me, there are five components of literacy. There are five components of literacy today. Are we literate? think about in these five terminologies. Number one, communication skills of alternative languages. How many languages we can speak is a very important measure in the literacy today. Because you know, in the world, the largest number of people are speaking Mandarin, not the English. And then of course, you know, Hindi and maybe English. So the English is only one language, but we stuck in English in Sri Lanka. But if you go out of Sri Lanka, you can see how many people speak how many languages. Now, your literacy will depend on whether you can speak third language, fourth language or fifth language. Because you know, the enormous information is generated through various alternative languages. The second component of literacy. So, with respect to literacy, I will show you a very small pathetic situation in Sri Lanka. We have 10,000 schools here. We have 10,000 schools. These 10,000 schools, 6,300 schools are running only by single language. Only single language. Now, ongoing schools, I am telling, the future generation literacy of Sri Lanka. And the 3,000 schools are only in Tamil language. And you see, English and Tamil and Sinhala and Tamil schools are very limited. Less than 1% or 2% of our total number of schools. So where we are going after 2 decades or 3 decades with respect to literacy. Okay? So this is kind of a future indicator whether our schools are teaching other languages or particularly this communication is very important. The second is, of course, you know, ICT literacy. ICT means, you know, information communication literacy. The definition is given here. I'm not going to elaborate because of my time constraint. I hope that my time will be very constrained because I have many things to tell you. Okay, now this is the outcome. You can see how many households are having desktop computers in Sri Lanka. The last year, the 2017, you can see it is only limited number of houses having, of course, 23%, 23.5% having the computers at home. So only 1/4 of Sri Lankans are having the computer at home. Then computer literacy, if you go, only 1/3 of Sri Lankans are having still computer literacy. Less than 28.3% people are having literacy, and that has a huge variation across the provinces and all these. So computer literacy side also, are we literate? So you can see only the 30%, less than 30% people are having the literacy with respect to computer, because you know, in today's world, the downloading is not the problem. Problem is the uploading, because large number of data, the mega data, big data, are uploaded every time to the internet and all these things. So therefore, a huge data set people are using. So whether we have access to this data, if we don't have computer literacy, we can't have it. So the second component also, because I'm critical, don't tell that I'm negative. I'm critical because we have to be critical as researchers to understand where we are going ahead. And the third component, financial literacy. Are we financially literate? This is very important concept for management graduates and even accountants and finance graduates. Are you financially literate? The financially literate means, in other words, if I tell, if you are fully financially literate means you are not working, your money is working and bring money for you. You just take only the decision where to invest the money. In other words, in Sri Lanka, this 230,000 employers, where they are not running, the people are working for them. They don't work for money. The money, their money is work for them, right? So therefore, that what we call all the time, are we financially literate? Because you know, even professionals in Sri Lanka working 18 hours per day, even 20 hours per day, the so-called very important professions in Sri Lanka, even at 50s, 60s, but they don't know what will happen to their money in the bank. Their money, where it invested, and money can generate more money, so that they are not using financial literacy in that sense. And of course, you can see what are the important components of financial literacy. These are the earning, income, spending and savings and investment, borrowing and protecting your finance. Are you financially literate? If you are financially literate, I will ask you, if you have 100,000 rupees in the savings bank, at the end of the 1 year, how much you will have now? If you have 100,000 in your savings bank, at the end of the year, how much you will have? In Sri Lanka, now it is 98,000. 98,000, remember that. Because the way how I do it, the very simple calculation, you have to adjust it to your interest rate, tax rate, and inflation rate. Interest rate, tax rate, and inflation rate. This is a kind of a typical example, but Sri Lankan context I took that. If you have 100,000, because your financial literacy will depend on, are you always calculating this one? These are the variables. Are you all the time thinking about your financial assets in terms of these indices? What are these? Interest rate, inflation rate. Are you calculating inflation rate and your money in the bank? If you keep a current account, it is going to be a seriously negative one, right? And the exchange rate, of course, is the one important thing. Without doing anything, sometimes company is losing because exchange rate is going. And overnight, you know, petrol prices, energy cost is here, the license fees are there, government and other charges are also improved. So this is the context what you are there. You have to be vigilant about what is happening to your money. So if you are not thinking about that, you are not financially literate. That is the simple example given. And if you are running a business, you have to go one step above. You need to calculate these variables. You know, these indices you have to calculate. The business people, they know that your business, your financial literacy, the profit or something will depend on all these indices. You can measure whether you are financially literate or not. So that is another component. And of course, if you want to develop your financial skills, I always tell them, read the, I'm giving this to take home for you. Read these two books. I started, I think, reading this 10 years before. The Rich Dad and Poor Dad. So this is very interesting and important thing. If you meet a school children, what is your advice today? I think generation wise, we are giving same advice. So if you meet a school children, or if you go to address grade 1 class, what is your advice? Learn hard, be the first in the class, go to good school, go to good university, get a first class, then the answer, final answer, you will get a job. The job, who is giving? Is that government? Government can't give the jobs. 60,000 on the road, the university graduates in Sri Lanka. Because their fathers and mothers repeatedly told the same story for them. And we are also teaching our kids, learn hard, get a first class, you will get a job. But who's giving the job? Is that government giving the job? Government can't give the job. Government can give the job, they will increase the tax, pay the salary. So that we have come to the limit, 1.4 million employees are here. Right? Public sector. But on the road, there are every year now 30,000 adding. Right? So what is the usual important thing? You need to think in terms of what is the rich dad telling to the his son. The rich dad is guiding his son. Don't think about the certificates. Try to identify your skill as early as possible. Maybe a different skill you are having, playing cricket, dancing, singing, or any skill, as early as identify, invest on that, develop on that, think about financial literacy. These two are very important. So we never teach financial literacy in Sri Lanka. I think in any level, if you take the primary school, secondary, tertiary, or university, even accountants, we never teach the financial literacy. So therefore, even accountants are in a trouble, country itself in a trouble, we have to give the money to other countries now. So the rich dad poor dad advice is very clear. So are we concentrate, we know the education, which usually defined with knowledge, skills and attitudes. This skill part, the financial literacy is a skill which is not taught and developed in the country like Sri Lanka. So financial skill stories, we don't have in our primary education also. Then you can see why the financial literacy is essential, because the financial stability of the country and the return on investment depend on the financial literacy. If the people don't have financial literacy, central bank cannot have economic stability, because you know people take loans, they can't pay back, they committed suicide in Sri Lanka. If you go to rural sector, that is quite obvious. And SME sector is quite obvious. And even You see, many policies are today to distribute money as loans to people, but they don't have financial literacy. Ultimately, what will happen? Inflation rate will go up like 7%, 8%. Your value of money is coming down. We all are suffering. So that is a simple thing. So therefore, that for the economic growth, the most important component is the financial literacy education for people. How to earn money, how to spend money, how to save money, how to get it done, work through the money will work, bring money for you. So that philosophy we need to understand. And of course, the fourth component of literacy, I do not know how many minutes I am having now.
Five more minutes,
okay, right. So now I explain you three components of the literacy. The fourth component of the literacy is networking and knowledge sharing. When we learn economics, of course, I also learned economics up to the PhD. So in economics, usually we will learn at the very beginning, resources are limited, but desires are unlimited. In modern world, there are unlimited resources. That is the system we have to identify. There are two unlimited resources. The one is the profit. The second is the networking. So if you have profit, you can go beyond any level. So access to profit is the main way to have the country's development step. You know why Japan is developed? Because I told you there are 4.2 million businesses. All they generate profit. So the Japanese government take the larger amount of tax from where? The profit. Even some larger company profit, they take 50%. 50% as the profit. In Sri Lanka, why government cannot take taxes? Because our profits are less. Profits are almost zero. We don't show the profit. The taxes on profit is very less in Sri Lanka. Because we can have access to five sources of income. We have land, labor, capital, entrepreneurship, all these we have. And we can get somebody else's income as well. But the only source of unlimited income is the profit. So access to profit. So that if we have more entrepreneurs, there will be more profit, then government can charge more tax from profit, not from the people. So why government is taking taxes from the people? No profit earners in the country. So that is also related to financial literacy, what I am talking on. And of course, again, if we go back to this networking and the knowledge sharing, these are two important aspects in today's literacy, because you need to network. The simple saying that what you matter is immaterial today. Who you know is more material. So therefore, these linkages and networking is very essential. In particularly when it comes to micro business, SMEs or the large businesses, the Japanese production system entirely depends on linkages, subcontract systems, and all they have clustering the relationships, networks. So in Sri Lankan business community, we don't have such network. So the networking is one of the important aspect of the literacy and knowledge sharing. And finally, of course, you know R&D. To develop the literacy and other thing, the research and development is essential. Now you can see how the expenses on research and development in Sri Lanka. It was earlier close to 2%, now it has come down less and less and less. So we do not do research. And some researchers, of course, as Professor Dharmasiri said, no point of doing that research because which are not showing any direction to the society, showing any direction to the business organizations. So therefore, what I thought that we need to rethink about, are we really literate? Where we are heading? Because many people think that if our policy is right, the foreigners will come here, invest money, generate jobs, they will take profit, and the country will prosper. But that will never ever happen. Why? Because we know the Sri Lankan situation is based on the very weak literacy. Because of this, you know what is happening. People take more loans, they can't pay back, there are issues. Country also same. Country also, we take more money as loans, which are not productive. Say for example, if you have produced one large infrastructure, you have to market it well. If you are not marketing, that is not profitable. I think thank you very much for giving this opportunity, particularly Dr. Namali and KDU for inviting us to do this presentation. Thank you.